Hiyo ni halali, hiyo ni halali kweli. Sisi tunaumia wachezaji, si mashabiki ndio tunaumia, lakini si wachezaji. Haya, nani nani na
Happy New Year, the first show of 2019. Welcome to Sportsugu. I'm your host, John Gigi. Remember, you can get interacting with us, that is through our SMS line number 21144. You can reach my Facebook page, that is at John Gigi. We are having quite some sporting action that happened during the over the weekend, whereby we had the Kenya Premier League, the FA Cup highlights, and also the La Liga happening. Remember to keep it until the end of the show, whereby we shall be discussing about the prediction center, where it all gets heated. To help me break down all these stories, my guests over here. Welcome, guys, to the show.
Thank you very much.
On the far end, Desire.
Thank you very much. It's an opportunity.
Happy New Year, first of all.
Happy New Year.
Good to see you.
I'm cool. Everything is fine. It's a new year. Just keeping up with the way it's going. Yes.
Dante over here.
Yeah.
I hope it's quite a good...
Happy New Year to Manchester United family. We are great.
Nilijua tu ungeanza hivyo show. Nilijua tu ungeanza na story ya Manchester United.
Unajua, okay. One thing...
Finally, let's... Okay. Finally, Mourinho sacked.
That is my happiness.
The happiest thing.
Yeah. I told you guys, last year, 2018, I told you Mourinho is not my favorite.
And we are seeing Manchester United bearing the fruits.
Yeah.
On to our first story, that is the Kenya Premier League. The Kenya Premier League started, and we are almost in the round of six matches, whereby we had Tusker, Sofapaka, where they played to a 3-2. KCB, Kariobangi Sharks, played to a draw. Bandari won 2-1. Mathare and Gor Mahia drawing 1-1. FC Leopard and Zoya drawing also. It's quite an interesting fixture, especially whereby we are having Mathare United and Gor Mahia. Dante, did you expect Mathare United to get a point to the defending champions Gor Mahia?
Yeah, that game totally. Gor Mahia, they didn't play unlike the last season. My prediction was Mathare United to beat Gor Mahia and to proceed there unbeaten form. So that match, Gor Mahia aqua fit.
Yeah. Desire.
Yes, that is.
What can you say about Mathare United? Juu tunaonanga ligi ikianza wanaanza gafiti, but ikifika pali wanapotelelea tu mara moja.
Yeah.
You think they are going to maintain this this run of good form?
I think in this time of the year and this time of the season, I think they wanaweza emulate hiyo form yao. Maybe tuseme they won't go unbeaten, but at least wanaweza try as much as they can to be up there. Because that high result ya weekend against Gor Mahia didn't come as a surprise, because Gor in their recent form hawajakuwa the Gor we know ya last season. So
still adapting to the new coach.
Gor Mahia, we have known them. They have they keep on having new coaches and they perform in every coach they have. But this season, you know, it's like they have won it. Now people are like they are used to them. I don't see this season if they emulate the other seasons like what they did. Mathare United just played their part and they ended in a 1-1 draw, which was a result of two penalties.
We are seeing there are also some other teams which are pushing up and they have been consistent. The like of Tusker, Bandari and now Kariobangi Sharks. We are seeing that the table is now separated by 2 and 1 points. We've seen that Bandari are in number 4, Tusker are in number 3. Western Steamer number 2, Kariobangi Sharks number 4.
Yes, you know Kariobangi Sharks is a team that we need to watch this season because it's a team which the owner has invested so much in it and it has great talent.
And not to forget, they were just eliminated in the
in the CAF. Yes. So now they have much to concentrate on the league, and I know this season they'll try hard. Maybe they can finish top four, or even they can finish maybe number two or three.
Dante.
Yeah.
Gor Mahia, they are in the eighth position with one game to spare. Do you think they are going to catch the rest of the pack?
It will be very hard because they are struggling a lot. First of all, the new coach is trying to figure out the upcoming players so that they can fit into his tactics and the shape that he wants to play.
But this is Kogalo, the Kogalo we all know.
You know, okay, yeah, we know that it's Kogalo, but being number eight, yet you are a champion of SportPesa Premier League.
Maybe we can give them a benefit of doubt because they have just moved from, they were in the second round, that is in the CAF Confederation playoffs. Maybe tunaweza sema wamechoka sana, ndio maana.
You see, it's very, no, listen, it's very shameful for an team kama Westerns team imetoka root juzi. Look at it, iko na 14 points. Gor Mahia wako na 6
points. But unajua ligi ikianza.
It's very shameful.
Ligi ikianza, Desire, if you can think you can relate with this. We also see it more often in the English Premier League. Hizi teams zenye ziko chini ndio zinakuaga pale juu, zina form table.
Maybe you say a point like that one, but ukisema the players are tired. Gor Mahia is a big club in Kenya. This is a team which, you know, a team consists of about 24, 25 players. So ukiniambia wako tired, uwezi sema players wote wako tired. This is a team which must have massive talent.
But you know, we cannot say that everyone that is in Gor Mahia ni world class. Pia tuwezi put hivyo. Because there are also some...
Not world class, but they are good players. Uh-huh. For you to feature in Gor Mahia, even in the substitute, you are a good player. So Gor Mahia is a big team.
So they should pull up their
socks.
So we are waiting to see if they will come up with that form. We know that the Gor Mahia we know. Mm. The Kogalo we all know. On to our second story, that is the La Liga. Many have said that we have neglected this league. I don't know if it's because Cristiano Ronaldo moved away and akatoa ile utamu ya ball yenye tulikuwa tunasema ile competition kati ya Messi na Cristiano Ronaldo. Over the weekend we had some quite interesting matches whereby Atletico Madrid and Sevilla played to a 1-1 draw. Real Madrid disappointing us and disappointing. Najua Dante alikuwa amewekelea hiyo game. So ulikuwa umeniambia
before. Yeah.
Real Sociedad humbled them 2-0. Barcelona winning 2-1 against Getafe. Desire, what's happening to Real Madrid?
Real Madrid is going through a massive big problem because, you know, we thought that when Cristiano leaves the club, he'll give a chance players like Gareth Bale to shine. But now you're seeing, you know, at first they played well, but now you see it is coming to haunt them. They don't have that individual brilliance we saw through Cristiano. You're asking a question.
But we are, you know, Real Madrid consists of, maybe let's say, they are world-class players, the likes of Isco and Asensio. But,
you know, yes,
we know Ronaldo alitoka na kauzito fulani, but pia Isco is one of the world-class players,
Yes, Isco is among the world-class, but you've seen in the recent form, Isco is falling out of favor in Real Madrid.
Actually, yes.
And Takako move out. Mm-hmm. So, you know, Real Madrid has massive talent, the likes of Luka Modric, who won the Ballon d'Or.
Junior.
Yes, but, you know, there's that one player, that thing that Cristiano Ronaldo left.
That one leader.
Individual brilliance. Mm-hmm. You know, Cristiano Ronaldo could carry the team, even when the whole team was out of form. He could do his thing and score goals and make Real Madrid win. But now we don't see that thing in Real. That is maybe something we are seeing is lacking in them. And then they don't have that winning mentality.
That's true.
It's long gone.
Because if you look at the table, Real Madrid are in the fifth place. Surprisingly, Alaves are in fourth position. Dante, you expected this to happen?
In addition to what my brother said here, I think Real Madrid are lacking leadership, the role model. Bale is trying his best, but the other players trying to fit to his, but is not the quality of role model Cristiano Ronaldo left.
But they
left.
Signed Courtois. You know Courtois is lead from the back.
No, you know when you're saying Courtois, you are trying to reflect to a certain team in England, which I don't want to refer to.
Which team is that?
No, I don't want to bring chaos here. Because that team has a good goalkeeper. Mm-hmm. But you see, you know, you have a good goalkeeper, but the squad was not performing, mm-hmm. yet you put the blame on the keeper. Courtois, as you
know. I know which team you're talking about.
Courtois, Courtois is a good goalkeeper. Uh-huh. But now, if the whole team is not performing, you can't put all the blame on Courtois. You know, let us concede and let us score more goals. We'll win the game. Mm-hmm. But if we are not scoring goals, will you still blame Courtois?
Quickly, maybe guys could tell me, do you think Real Madrid will finish in the Champions League position?
Quickly. Real Madrid, when they reach Champions League, they know very well that we are going for a business. Real Madrid, for me, I think Real Madrid are the best to lift the Champions League trophy.
Champions League not finishing in the top four position in the La Liga.
Yeah.
But quite interesting predictions over there. Because you can't compare La Liga and the UEFA Champions League.
You can't compare both of them. If you see, Real Madrid are best in Champions League and they are defending champions of the trophy.
So you think they are going to win?
They are going to defend it.
The fourth time?
Yeah.
Hey. No, my... No.
I think Man United.
You know.
That's quite interesting.
That's interesting. I think I'm going to differ with you. Mm-hmm. They can't retain the trophy again.
Not in the fourth position.
We know.
And seeing the form that Juventus are, PSG are,
Man City are.
That doesn't matter.
No, Man City.
That doesn't matter.
I don't think Man City.
Why are you saying that? You know,
because it takes quite a strong mentality to reach in the finals of the UEFA Champions League.
And what brings
and
the mentality?
Manchester City lacks sometimes that.
Sometimes. What brings the mentality?
I don't want to say, but I think
no,
Manchester City.
But
will not
Real Madrid
be a man.
Are the best favor for me to lift the trophy.
Desire.
And they have the quality of players that they know very well that if you go to the pitch. You're going for a business.
Desire, do you think Real Madrid will finish in the fourth position
yes,
before we go?
I'm sure of that. They'll finish
break.
Maybe number three.
Number
Second
three.
Leg, we'll see them work out. Maybe mm-hmm. they'll do their things one, two, sign a new coach. Uh-huh. They'll finish. Real Madrid is a big team.
Maybe Mourinho is going there.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So Arsene Wenger, I see more of Arsene Wenger. Oh, Mourinho, no.
So you think Scolari will not finish the season?
I don't think so.
He was just given the contract just the other day.
And that is Real Madrid. They need that transition fast. Uh-huh. It's not like other teams.
Like?
No, I don't want to say.
Desire ajaribu kuhepa tu hizo story za Manu na
si ati anahepa. Unajua, okay, Real Madrid ni kama wanafanya biashara ya makoach unlike players. Uh-huh. Look at the coaches that they have signed since the club started. It's like Chelsea. For now, Chelsea.
But I think
Chelsea.
Teams,
Chelsea wame sign more coaches. Uh-huh. For now, wame sign 22 coaches than uh-huh. any other club in there.
But no. That's where Arsene Wenger won regime at Arsenal. 20. Let's take a quick break. We shall be right back with the prediction center and the FA Cup highlights. See you then.
The best seat for the world's greatest football leagues is the one you're sitting on. The 2018-19 season is front row football. It's DStv or nothing, so make it yours with our incredible special offer. Available for a limited time only. It's unrivaled football on SuperSport, only on DStv.
SmackDown goes live. Here we go.
Oh, beautiful.
Ready for every heart-stopping moment of SmackDown Live. Get all the action live in an HD every Wednesday at 3 or in primetime later the same day at 8. This is the home of WWE, where there's sport, there's DStv.
Welcome back. The question of the day we are asking, scorer of English Premier League, our SMS line number remains to be 2-1-1-4. Send us your feedback and we shall be sampling them at the end of the show. Guys, this is the part that you all wait for. That is the prediction center and also the FA Cup highlights. I know the English Premier League was on a break, but we had something to entertain us over the weekend in Europe, whereby there were big wins for Manchester United, Chelsea, Everton, Manchester City, Watford, Leicester, Tottenham, and of course, Arsenal. We've seen that the round three of the FA Cups are over. And now almost all the big teams are into the next round. Apart from Liverpool, which will be playing today against Wolves, which is a hard nut to crack that team. According to these results that happened over the weekend, which team do you think will go all the way to win the FA Cup this time, or do you think Chelsea will retain the cup?
For me, actually, it's very unpredictable because each and every team reaching FA finals, as in maybe the round of another step, it's gonna be a very hard for both teams. Okay, Tottenham, I think they'll go through, beating up all these big four teams and emerging the winner of the FA.
To you, which team do you think, let's not even go to the final.
Yeah.
Semi-finals too. Zile teams known as it Africa, the best four teams in the semi-finals.
Manchester United, uh-huh. Manchester City, uh-huh. Tottenham, and I think Arsenal.
Desire.
Yes.
I only need four semi-finalists in this this FA Cup competition this year, according to you.
Manchester City, mm-hmm. Chelsea, Arsenal, and Tottenham.
So Manchester United at Waoni?
No, we won't see Manchester United. You know, this is the FA Cup. Mm-hmm. Manchester United, maybe they can get one giant killer. Mm-hmm. You know, Manchester United is not a team that will expect more of other trophies. Maybe what they'll fight this season tough for is to
Europa League.
Maybe to get in the Champions League. Mm-hmm. So when they'll be much concentrating on the league because they're in a good form. Mm-hmm. I told you na kikosia game yao ya FA against Reading. If Reading was just a clinical team, I think it could have inge get past Manchester United.
That's true.
Because I tell you, number passes.
I want to differ with my brother here. I want to differ with him first.
I was actually saying that, yes, Manchester United will go, let's say, to game nine if you're unbeaten. Mm. But when the storms and the rain starts to fall on them, I'm telling you, they're going to go back to the where they
I want to differ both of you. First of all, it's very shameful for a big team to play a smaller or a root team, putting all your best players. Look at Man City, look at Tottenham, Walieka, as in my players, wote, knowing that this is a root team. Look, angalia game, which is Manchester United versus Reading, Walieka, at least my player.
Maybe, the other teams, maybe they don't have those young players.
Hiyo ni form ya kuwa uoga, hiyo ni kuwa muoga. So, you're not telling anything.
Let's say, wacha kidogo. Tuseme Manchester United wangetoka.
Yeah.
Bado ungesema ati kwa sababu ati ya uoga yao walieka watu see team A.
No.
Eh?
No.
If Man City tungechapwa na Rotherham na tumeka a lesser team, ungesema tulichapwa. Nikijitetea tulikuweka team B, ungesema mbona tukweka team A.
Listen.
And the next thing unafujue FA is the yondo the trophy meka sana English Premier League. That is the most traditional trophy in England. So and ukiangalia sisi Man City hata tuleka nini inaitwaje ni ka team B kwa sababu most of our players hawakucheza game against Liverpool. Yeah. Tuko na depth. And most of our players wanajulikana.
Actually, let's say team B ya Manchester City.
Okay. I want to differ with my brother here. How many cups have you won? FA.
That was not the question.
Compared to Manchester United
versus
Arsenal.
That was not the question.
No, just answer my question.
How many cups?
Won more. You have won more. You have won
four?
More than us.
Four?
You have won more than us.
Not even four.
Not but even four. But
the question was, the question was, itakuwaje team bigi mnaweka ma players wote, and like mnacheza na Harambee Stars mnaweka Man City wote.
That is a trophy. Yeah? That is a trophy. You need to win. We need to win trophies.
Let's say season hakuna ile game yenye ni less.
Season
so each and every game, coach lazima ichukue.
So, can you both guys define what football is?
Football is playing a team having 11 players each,
against
and it doesn't matter first team or second team. If tungechapo, it is still Manchester City. If we are winning, it's still Manchester City. Unasema bigger players, unaongelea De Bruyne.
You know,
De Bruyne amekuwa out
for
how many
months? At the end of the day, even if the team is Team A or Team B, the results matter a lot.
The results matter. Jota ananishangaza akisema tulicheza team A because Kangalia Walker was not in the game against Liverpool.
That's
De Bruyne
true.
Was not there. Gabriel Jesus was not there. Philip Sandler was not there. Phil Foden was not there.
That's
Gundogan
the
was not
Manchester
there. You know,
United.
These are the people
Manchester
I'm telling
City.
You.
No.
And they were there. And they were there
so,
in the game.
So, okay.
So,
listen. Skiza. So, ilikuwa your happiness, you guys beating up a team 7-0. Yet,
for you saying to like a big player, tebu niambia big players tuliyechezesha.
Yeah.
Niambia big players wenye tulichezesha wenye wako first 11.
Akina Sterling.
Sterling ako first 11 1. Sana lingia dakika ngapi?
No.
The
question is alicheza ama kucheza?
Rashford alicheza ama kucheza?
Alicheza.
Lukaku alicheza ama
kucheza?
Alicheza.
Ashilianga
alicheza ama
kucheza?
Alicheza. Na Ashilianga
alicheza.
Sanchez alicheza.
Sanchez is not a first 11.
No. Aya,
ndio mimi nakwambia Gundogan is not a first 11. Nani, Walker,
let's say that at the end of the day, the results matter a lot.
The results matter.
So there were big wins for no disappointment for the top guns. Every team secured its win and to the next round. I hope to see the draw, how it will come. I hope tugonganishwe, team kubwa zigonganishwe hapa.
Yes,
at least your gap yenda ikireduce kiasi. So maybe quickly, guys, before we enter the prediction center to you. And as I had asked earlier, who do you think will be the EPL top scorer this season? 2018-2019 season. Who do you think
me,
to you?
For me, I'll keep on saying that it's very unpredictable, seeing the like of Lacazette, Aubameyang, Hazard, Martial. They are, okay, they want to prove more that they can win.
Okay. As per now, we are saying that
okay, for
Harry
me,
Kane and Aubameyang are tying up.
For me, Harry Kane is the best. And I'm voting for that guy to lift up the golden boot.
Mm-hmm. So you go with Harry Kane?
I go with Harry Kane.
Okay. What about you, Desire?
Yeah, I go with Aubameyang.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Arsenal is a team that creates chances.
Mm-hmm.
We have seen that this season. And they're looking more of their strikers. Mm-hmm. You've seen Lacazette and Aubameyang, and their connection is quite good.
Quite good.
So I'm seeing Aubameyang going with it.
Aubameyang.
Yes.
You know,
a Manchester fan told me that Aubameyang will be surprised to see Harry Kane carrying the day.
No, Harry Kane is just a good scorer, but you know, Aubameyang even can score a hat-trick, even can score four goals
that's,
in a game.
That's what I was telling you.
What about Aguero?
You know, Aguero will not be far.
Injury. And before I catch up now,
Lakini ajashinda na Aubameyang, ameshinda around four goals.
Let's wait and see.
He was going to support Aguero.
And why didn't you support Lukaku?
We enter into the prediction center. I know where this is where it gets heated up and you guys almost fight each other. We have inside quite some good matches whereby West Ham playing against Arsenal, Brighton playing against Liverpool, Chelsea against Newcastle, Manchester City against Wolves, and also we have in Wolves against Liverpool, as we had earlier said, that is the FA Cup playing today. But our focus today is Manchester United versus Tottenham Hotspur. Wembley match, revenge match. I know Manchester United want to revenge and show that they are still the top guns.
Yeah.
Dante,
for me,
Manchester United carrying the day?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a Manchester United family.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the Manchester United players are going to show the world that we are not the descendant of Mourinho.
Mm-hmm.
Now that the new coach has come.
I know it feels good to play tiki-taka.
Yeah. So Tottenham
we are coming for you.
So what's your prediction? How many goals do you see?
You don't want so many goals. I think 2-1.
A 2-1, Manchester United win.
2-1, Manchester United win.
Quite interesting. Desire.
This is a big test for Manchester United. Tumona for me out the recent games. And Pia Tottenham, what a corner lag.
Bearing in mind, Heung-min Song will not be available. Not
so that is what makes the game more difficult. I see a draw.
A draw?
Yes. I
How
see
many
a draw.
Goals?
1-1.
1-1. So it's a GG affair.
Yes, it's
and
a
also
goal affair.
It's an over affair. Yeah.
Ah.
It's also a win affair.
Win affair.
No, you can't win.
So the investors have quite a lot of options to choose from.
But let the recent form of Manchester United
not deceive
investors. This is Tottenham, and we know what they can do. They did it in Old Trafford, in front of 80,000 seat capacity. And they still won
so
the match.
So, the question I want to ask, when Man City was playing Leicester City, when Man City was playing Crystal Palace, did you say that investors to...
I was not in the show that time. But this is a different.
Let's say this is English Premier League. Surprises are bound to happen.
Yes, but and be in mind that these are top two. Mm-hmm. There are two big teams, and Tottenham are up there. They don't want to lose it, and Manchester United still want to be in the top four. So it's going to be an interesting match.
An interesting match over here, as our analysts are telling us. Okay, we come to the end of the show. Remember to keep it Sportsugu. Until next time, I've been your host, John Gigi.
Hiyo ni halali, hiyo ni halali kweli. Sisi tunaumia wachezaji, sisi mashabiki ndio tunaumia, lakini si wachezaji. Haya, nani? Na